Pulbar conjunctiva, which cover the inner surface of the eyelids. Bulbar conjunctiva, which cover the sclera. Bulbar conjunctiva is transparent. Pulbar conjunctiva is pale pink, smooth and moist. And place of the adjunction is called conjunctival fornix. Every eye has two conjunctival fornices, superior and inferior. To examine them, we can't examine them without aversion of the eyelids. Mm-hmm. It's necessary to remove eyelids and then examine. If you so during the credits, it will be like this: you come in pairs. One will be a doctor, other will be a patient. Who will be your partner? It's your own choice. So you it doesn't matter for us. So you'll be in pairs. You come together only with these individual cards. Yes, filled individual cards. So then every of you will take three cards. On every card there will be number of skills. For example. You take card number 1, 10, and 23. It means you should perform these three skills on your partner. Then he will be a doctor, you will be a patient, you change your roles. If you take card number 1 or number 2, examination should be the same. Because it's you can't examine foreignnesses without aversion, and it's not necessary to averse without examination. Yes. For the sport industry, of course. So, if you take card number 1 or number 2, you should do the same. First, averse, then examine. Both eyes. So, position of the lamp, like in case of focal illumination, you should prepare a lens 20 diopters, and now I'm free for aversion and examination of conjunctival fornix. Let's start with the easiest examination of the lower conjunctival fornix. And so, aversion of the lower orbit. We ask the patient to look up. We put the thumb of free hand at distance about half centimeter from the margin of the lower eyelid, look up, and pull it down like this. Now you see fold of conjunctiva. This is lower conjunctival fornix. And now you can examine. It's really pale pink, smooth and moist. If, look down please. In this position you can't reverse, can't see. So your patient should help you, ask him to look up. Then pull down and you see fold. This is lower conjunctival fornix. And this is a version of low eye. Very easy. Conclusion, low conjunctival pharynx without pathology. A version of the upper eyelid. Several steps, step by step. First step, you ask the patient to look down, only with your eyes. So look down. Now put the thumb at the upper eyelid, a distance about also half centimeter, like in case of low eyelid, and pull it up. Now you can grasp the upper eyelid. Now you can grasp it. Of course, you can try to grasp it in this position of the upper eyelid without pulling it up. But you usually manage to grasp only eyelashes, and it will be painful. You can also touch to the cornea, and cornea is the most sensitive structure of the anterior surface. And you know, I mean, girls know when you brush your eyelashes, if you touch occasionally to the cornea, lacrimation, the same amount of pain, and so not comfortable situation. To exclude it, we ask the patient to look down and pull up the apartment. In this position, even if I'll touch to the white sclera and conjunctiva which covered it, there will be no problem at all. No, it's not so painful. Look up, look down please, pull up, now grasp. Grasp not only eyelashes but also upper eyelid. Now pull it down a bit, I mean the upper eyelid. Now tip of the thumb, put a distance 1 centimeter from the margin of the eyelid. And now grasp around the tip of the... Is it painful?
No.
Then you have a free hand, take the lens and examine. It's the inner surface of the upper eyelid. Pale pink, smooth and moist. Clear? No, we'll train till the Friday of the next week, yes? Every day you can examine each other, you can...